In this video series, we will show you how to check the machine accuracy and calibrate your machine if necessary. Part 1 of 3 shows how to use the micrometer correctly. The micrometer comes with your machine as part of the accessory case. It is needed to measure test specimens and calibration specimens. We provide 2 extra videos which show you step by step how to manufacture and measure these specimens. You can find the links in the video description below. The micrometer is a high precision instrument that measures to 1/1000th of a millimeter. Only with this instrument can you measure test and calibration specimens with sufficient accuracy. Notice: never use common measuring instruments like rulers or calipers. Here is an overview of the different parts of the micrometer: the measuring spindle and surface, the brake, the on-off button, the quick drive, which is the small rotary knob, and the ratchet, which is the big rotary knob. With the quick drive, you can move the measuring spindle to cover greater distances quickly. The ratchet is for fine adjustments of the measuring spindle in the last few millimeters. It is equipped with a torque mechanism which will trigger as soon as the measuring surface touches a surface. You will hear the clicking sound of the torque mechanism as you continue to turn the ratchet and the measuring spindle doesn't move any further. In summary, use the quick drive to get close to the surface which you want to measure and then use the ratchet until its torque mechanism is triggered. Before using the micrometer, make sure that the measuring surfaces are absolutely clean. If necessary, use a clean cloth. Before you can start measuring, you have to set the zero point of the micrometer. Without a correct zero point, all measurement values will be incorrect. Switch on the micrometer by pressing the on-off set button. Adjust the measuring surfaces to a distance of approximately 2 millimeters with the quick drive. Then slowly turn the ratchet until the measuring surfaces touch each other and the torque mechanism was triggered. Now press and hold the on-off set button for 3 seconds. The value 0.000 on the display indicates that the zero point is set. The micrometer is now ready for measuring. Now practice the correct handling when measuring with the micrometer. Take a test and calibration disc from the accessory case. Grasp the micrometer with one hand at the insulated handle. Use the quick drive to open the measuring spindle until the disc fits in between. If there is a greater distance between the measuring spindle and the specimen, use the quick drive to reduce the distance to approximately 2 millimeters. For the last 2 millimeters, slowly turn the ratchet clockwise until the measuring surface touches the specimen and you hear the clicking sound of the torque mechanism. If you continue to turn the ratchet, the distance value on the display shouldn't change. Notice: make sure that the measuring surface lies flat on the specimen and not slanted. Measure each point at least twice to make sure that the measured values are correct. It is very important that you always follow these steps when measuring, as incorrect measurement is the greatest source of error when using the micrometer. This leads to incorrect calibration results. One of the biggest mistakes when measuring is to use only the quick drive to move the measuring spindle. As the quick drive has no torque mechanism, only using the quick drive will lead to a compression of the specimen and significantly incorrect measurement results. Here is an example of how the measured values differ between an incorrect measurement and a correct measurement. When measuring correctly with the ratchet, we measure a disc height of 10.450 millimeters. By measuring with the quick drive instead, the disc gets compressed and the measured value is greatly falsified. Another mistake when measuring is to place the micrometer at an angle on the specimen. This will also significantly falsify the measuring result. As you have seen in this video, it is really important to learn how to use the micrometer correctly before measuring calibration or test specimens. If your measured values are imprecise, your calibration will fail. Incorrect usage of micrometers is a common reason for machine downtime. We provide 2 separate videos to show you how to check the accuracy of your machine and how to recalibrate your machine if necessary. As mentioned before, you can find the links in the video description below. For a comprehensive knowledge base about VHF dental machines and DentalCam, visit dentalportal.info. We hope that this was helpful. Thank you for watching.